Okay, good afternoon, Sekolah Pilar Indonesia. Good morning, good afternoon, distinguished parents, our beloved students, and all viewers of Sekolah Pilar Indonesia YouTube channel. It's such a lovely day for us to have a virtual presentation today to meet online. And we're so grateful and we're going to thank God for everything we've got. And today, we are safe, we are healthy at home. Before we start today's activities, to this presentation, I would like to introduce myself first. My name is Teguh, and I teach English for grade 7, 8, and 9 SMP Pilar Indonesia. And today I will lead this event, an Interlink Project virtual presentation. Okay, grade 7 will present what they have been working for this month, about a month. They have been working so hard to create something. They've got an interlink project of 4 subjects, which are science, English, art, and ICT. In science, they learn about characteristic and classification of living things, and students chose either an animal or plant to research about. And in English, they learn how to describe them. They learn how to describe, how to make a descriptive writing to describe something, describe the animals or the living things they chose. And in art, they learn about illustration drawing. They draw and sketch the animals or plan for the book cover. While in ICT, they learn to organize and making the layout for their book. And all students have worked so hard to create their first book. And today, they will present it to you. They're going to present their book to us all. So let's just get started the presentation. Let's start the presentation. We're going to have 6 students presenting their book for this part. We have already got, we have done the first part of our virtual exhibition, which is in this morning. We've got we've got another 6 students, and in this part we will have another 6 students, which are Valdi, Egan, Barera, Alva, Edu, and Diki. They're going to present their book. Okay, so now let's invite the first presenter, the first students, to join with me, which is Valdi. Hello, Valdi. How are you?
I'm doing just fine.
Thank you very much, Valdi. So, are you ready to present the book?
Yes, I'm ready. Yes.
Okay, so what animals or what plants or what living things do you choose?
So, my living thing topic is about ants.
Okay, it's about ants. Okay, then, it's going to be interesting. Okay, you may start your presentation, Valdi.
Okay, so my name is Valdi, okay, and I'm going to present my interlink project, which is the book of living things, and it's about ants. Let me just share screen. Can you see the screen?
Yes. And said clearly. That's very nice drawing.
Okay, so good morning and good afternoon. This is my book. So this is my cover about ants. Let's just scroll down. So this is the preface where I just explain why I made this book, and I hope that everyone will enjoy it. This is the table of contents, so you can figure out where the pages are. And this is the chapter 1 introduction. In this chapter, I explain about the simple stuff of the ants, the overview of what is going to be in the other chapters. And I just do that, yes. Chapter 2, classification. So in this chapter, I explain how we classify ants, the type of ants. So the kingdom, the phylum, the class, the order, the family, subfamily, genus, and species. And we use all these steps to identify the type of ants. This is the common meat ant. The classification of the common meat ant. The Anomalia, Arthropoda, class Insecta, order Hymenoptera, family Formicidae, subfamily Dolichodirinae, and genus Iridomyrmex, and the species Purpurus. And this is chapter 3, description. And in this chapter, I explain the, what's it called? The parts of the ants and the functions of the parts. Yeah, and I also explain the stuff that the that the ants are divided into three parts: head, the thorax, and the abdomen. And they have a petiole that connects the thorax to the abdomen. So some have one segment and some ants have two segments. Chapter 4 is the habitat. In this chapter, I explain how ants can be found and how the colonies of ants work and where they usually put the ant colonies. Chapter 5, I explain the benefits of ants. I explain how they can protect lawns and are very helpful to the environment. And these are the references that I got all of that information from. That's it. So are there any questions?
Okay then, well done, Valdi. You presented so well, so confidently. Thank you very much, Valdi. This is talking about N, which is so interesting. So, well, guys, do you have any questions to Valdi about the books, about the topic that Valdi has already presented? Anyone?
I do.
This meeting? Okay, Egan. Egan, you have a question?
Okay. Should I start the video or just turn it off?
Start a video.
What fascinates you about ants that persuades you to make a book about it?
Well, that's a very good question. What fascinates you, Valdi, so that you make a book about ants?
Yeah, so I pick ants because before I was a kid, I was scared of ants. And I wanted to know more about the ants because the tiny little insects, they can do big stuff. So I wanted to find out more information about ants. So I made the book.
Very good answer, Valdi. That's awesome. So you've got like a, well, not scary experience, but then you know that ants is a like very little thing, but then it can do big things as well. Thank you again for your questions. Any other questions? Everyone is we're going to open the question and answer session for
me.
Probably. Okay, Abin. Please turn on the camera.
Yes, Abin. I remember when you really hate ants, but do you ever touch one? A big one.
Okay, Valdi, that's a question from Abin. Since Abin has been your friend for so long, right? He knows you so well, and okay, maybe he knows that you're afraid of ants. Have you ever touched the big ants, Valdi?
Yeah, so I have touched an ant, but not big ants, usually just little ants. When I like to drink, usually the ants are inside my cup, so I have to get them away from my cup. But the big ants usually aren't there, so I have no reason to touch them.
Okay, good. Thank you very much, Valdi. Maybe we can have one more question for Valdi, and we're going to go to the next students to present their book. Any other questions? Go on. Oh, we're talking about ants, which is very interesting. So, Valdi has mentioned some facts, some information about ants, and those information, those data, those information, those explanations are very helpful. So anyway, maybe I'm going to ask you questions, Valdi. So maybe you have actually mentioned the benefits of ants, but in your opinion, what is the most beneficial things about ants anyway from your research?
The most beneficial thing of ants. Mm-hmm. That's a hard question.
Based on your research, based on you know.
Well, my research, I don't know, but that's a good question. Maybe after this, I should research more about that.
Thanks
for the question. It's really good.
Okay, anyway. Well, Rico, raise his hand. So, Rico, are you going to ask questions for Valdi?
Yes.
Okay, maybe this is the last question for Valdi. Okay, Rico, so please ask.
So, you said you were scared of ants. When did you specifically, at what age, like, or at what grade did you stop being afraid of ants?
Okay, that's okay, let's answer it quickly.
And what do you think is the most scary part of ants?
Okay, what's the most scary part of ants? The scariest part from an ant. Okay, this is like a very personal opinion and very personal experience. Polly? Okay, just remember, at what time?
I started being more brave about ants when at the middle of grade 6, and the most terrifying part of ants, their tiny little faces, their horrifying little, and their hairy bodies, disgusting, and I hate them.
Okay, this is a very personal opinion, right? Because actually ants has very big parts in our ecosystem. Right, thank you very much for this. It's a very beautiful presentation, and you have done a very good job creating your first book. So you still have my questions, right? What are the most beneficial thing about ants? So you're going to do research about that one. Thank you very much anyway, Valdi. Good job. Okay, next we're going to continue to the next students to present their book, to present the book. And I'm going to invite Egan to join with us. Hello, Egan. Please turn on your camera again. All right, Egan. So are you ready to present your book?
Yeah.
Yes. Okay. Egan, you may start it.
Good evening. My name is Egan, and in this Interlink project, I wrote a book about dolphins. So this is the preface, the process of me making this book, like what, who taught us, how to use the apps, what website to use for researching and other stuffs. This is the table of content that can direct you to the pages. So if you want to specifically go to one chapter, you can see the number of pages here. The chapter one introduction is where the facts of dolphins you need to know before you read the whole book. hand classification is like what does specifically bottlenose dolphins classifies from the kingdom all the way to their species. Chapter 3, parts and function, is like the parts of their body and their function to adapt themselves in the environment. The habitats is where I explain where you can find dolphins and when. And when does the dolphin start to migrate? The benefits of dolphins that this chapter explains is all the benefits that dolphins play and as a role, a big role to the ecosystem. This is my sources that I use to research my informations.
Okay.
Any questions?
Is that all again?
Yeah.
Okay, good. Thank you very much. You can stop your screen. Thank you very much again, talking about dolphins. So maybe I'm going to start the questions. I'm going to ask you a question and the other will ask you a question, maybe some questions. Okay, again. Why is it dolphins? Why it has to be dolphins? What makes it just dolphins?
It's interesting, like it's one of the few mammals that live in water.
Okay, so yeah. So you can, everyone, you can see the, okay. Bongi. All right then. So do you, any other questions from everyone here?
Me.
From his friend? Okay, who's going to just-
Me again, Abin again, okay.
Abin again, Abin. Okay, Abin, turn on your camera.
Okay, mm-hmm. So what's the most difficult part of this book? Ikan.
Definitely researching, like I have no problem writing it, but I need to research many informations and make sure the sources are trusted. So I don't want to use false information in my book.
Good.
Okay.
That's a very good answer again. So maybe again doesn't have any problem with writing, but then research is the most crucial part here, right? You have to do research by using like valid in what is resources and something. Thank you very much again. Well,
Patago,
yes,
may I ask a question?
Okay, yes, Ibu.
Again, after writing the book on dolphins, do you have any, what is it? Any, do you have any wish after this? I would like to do related to dolphins. What is it?
Like, honestly, I'm just like trying to spread information about dolphins, and like, I mean, they're a protected species from the government, so yeah.
Okay.
I'm just trying to spread information and awareness about it.
And Egan, have you ever seen a real dolphin?
Yes.
Where is it?
Like in the sea, like near shore waters, and like in aquariums. Yeah.
Oh, okay. Here in Jakarta?
Yes, sometimes. And I saw one in Lampung also.
Okay, that's good. That's
in
good.
Many places.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you again. Thank you, Patagu.
Thank you, Natasha, for the question. Is there any other questions for Egan? So everyone, you can see Egan's book in this website, in this link. So everyone, if you want to look more or read more about the book that Egan has written, you can go to this link and yeah, you can read it there. Do we still have any questions for Egan about dolphins? Okay, maybe again, I'm going to ask you a question. Okay, how many types of dolphins have you, do you know? That maybe we can have like pink dolphins or some other dolphins?
Like the species, bottlenose, pink dolphins, orca, or killer whale, like whales are like, they're like close families to dolphins also, because even though they're aquatic animals, they still need oxygen from the surface.
All right, good. So then dolphins is actually famous for its they're smart. People say that they're smart, right? So
yes.
Can you please tell us about this thing that maybe you have ever read or have done some research about this one, about the smartness of these dolphins?
They have a very big intelligence for animals. Like the like if you look at dolphins, like they have a big head that's called the melon. So inside the melon is like the brain, and the melon is specially designed to catch sound waves from other dolphins and recognize it that it's a communication from others.
Okay, that's interesting. Is it called echolocation? Echolocation?
Yes.
Something? Okay. Well, thank you very much, Egan. All right, do we still have any more questions? Maybe we can open one more question for Egan. Okay, if there's no questions, thank you very much again. Well done, you have presented the topic clearly and you have done a very good research. We know that you have done very good research. You have read like so many resources on that you can explain about these dolphins clearly. Thank you very much again. Well done. Okay, so let's go to the next students to present the book. After Egan, we have already got ants by Valdi, dolphins by Egan. Now we're going to go to another animal. This one is a four-legged animal, and we're going to invite Barrera to present her book. Hello, Barrera. Hi, Barrera, how are you?
Good.
Okay, so are you ready to present your book, Barrera? Yes. So what is it about, Barrera?
We're gray wolves.
Okay, gray wolves. Okay, then Barrera, you can start your presentation.
Okay. Sebentar ya Pak, error.
Okay, we're going to wait. So Barrera is going to talk about werewolf. So during this the process, all the students have tried their best to actually show their understanding. They learn about these animals and plants in science, about how to classify them, about how do scientists classify the animals based on their phylum, kingdom, species, and so on. I don't remember the sequence, but then they have known that some animals share some similarities, or maybe they are close to each other, so they can be classified into some the same species or the same phylum or the same genus. And in art, okay, as you can see from Valdi and Egan's presentation, that they draw the cover. Okay, so Barrera, are you ready for this one? Okay, just directly share your screen.
So this is my cover.
Okay, wait a second, Barrera, we cannot see it. Okay, yes, no. Oh, beautiful. Yeah, you can start it, yes.
Okay. This is my preface. This is the table of content from the chapter 1 until chapter 5 and references. So this is chapter 1 of What Are Gray Walls? And this is about like their life story and their journey and everything. And about the other species, chapter 2. And this is the chapter 3, food and eating habits. This it's how they eat and then what they eat. They mostly eat like beaver, rabbit, fish, or something like that. This is chapter 4, population and conservation. Like how many are wolves now, and like more, and where are they now? And chapter 5, lastly, wolf pack. Well, wolf pack is like their family, wolf pack, like usually how many people that, I mean like how many wolves gather together. And this is the differences, and then
okay, so can we see your cover, Berera? Because that one is very eye-catching and it's very beautiful, in my opinion. So you draw it yourself, right?
Yeah, and this one.
You draw it yourself, right?
Yeah, jadi aku gambar. I draw from like a normal paper, and then I continue it at digital drawing.
Okay, that's awesome. That's very cool. A very good drawing. So it's a gray wolf. Thank you, Wolf. Thank you very much, Pereira. You may close your screen. And we're going to have like some question for you. Okay, you may close the screen. And well, everyone, guys, do you have questions for Pereira? She has tried to explain about what she has what is written here about wolf. So if you want to read Barrera's book, you can go to this link and you can get Barrera's book. It's not sold anyway, this is for free for right now. Maybe later on they're going to sell the book, but for now it's free. Okay, so any questions? Okay, but it's network is slow. Okay, maybe we can have some questions. Well, anyway, any questions for Barrera about this, the topic that she has presented about gray wolf? Okay, maybe I'm going to start.
At the girl?
Yes, Ibu.
Okay, I want to give some comments for three of them who has okay, presented their work.
Okay, Ibu Wulan.
Okay, thank you, Pak Teguh.
Yes, Ibu.
Excellent for three of you. You explain your ideas in a very clear voice so we can understand what you have for your project. You draw the picture in a very beautiful one, even for the ants, for the wolf, and also for the egans. One is about the dolphin. Is it right, dolphin?
Dolphins, yeah. Yes.
Barrera, I just want to have a question for you now. Why do you choose a wolf as your interlink project for your book? Because it's something, what is it, special, of course, for you. You decide to choose this animal. Thank you, I think. Can you answer it now, dear?
Yes, Berela.
I picked that because long time ago that was my favorite animal, and then like when I was like 5 years old, I want to be a werewolf, wolves. So why not?
Wow, that is it. Yeah, and it's you make it interesting for everyone. Maybe it will be good next for what is it? Make it the real book, yeah, Pak Teguh, and we can keep it in our library. Make your beautiful picture for the wall, so our our little sister from ECC, maybe like Mario, also little brother from ECC, will learn more about the animal, about wolf and about dolphin, and also about the ants. Okay, yeah. Grade 7. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Ibu Wulan, for the question and for the comments. Okay, so we hope soon that Berera and all students can create their book, and so everyone can read it in the library and everywhere. Okay, well, we still have any some questions for you, Berera. Can you please still turn on your video, your camera? We have a question from Reza here. Well, Reza, I need you to ask the question yourself. Okay, Reza. You have a question to Berera, right? Please just ask the questions yourself. You wrote something here in the chat, but can you please say it yourself? Can you please ask the question yourself, Reza? Yes. Reza?
Yeah, hello.
Okay, you have questions to Berera, right?
My voice?
Yes, we can hear your voice. Sorry, we can hear your voice. Can you hear my voice? Can you hear my voice, Reza? Well then, well, he has a question, Berera. Is dog and wolf the same? Or they are different? Are dogs and wolves the same, or are they different? Berera.
What is the question?
So, Jidan, sorry, Reza. Reza, sorry, Reza has a question. Are wolf and dogs the same? Wolf and dog. Do you think they are the same or they're different?
Actually, their species are the same, like dog and wolf is the same, but habitatsnya is different, and like their genus, I don't know.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I think they're the same family, but then the species can be different. So we can have like some species of ducks or wolf, right? But they share some similar features between the dog and the wolf. Okay, thank you. So any other questions for Berera?
One.
Okay, Ibu Natasha.
Berera. Is a wolf also, can you have a pet, a wolf as a pet, since you like wolves?
Actually, I think
it's dangerous.
You can, but maybe.
Okay.
I think that's illegal.
We better not have a wolf as a pet. Okay.
Probably if you want to have, you keep it as from baby, and then when it's already big. You set it free to the forest.
Yeah. Okay.
Or maybe thank you. Husky has the same look as a wolf. Okay, that's the type of a dog, and we can pet that type of dog, husky, Siberian husky. I think that has the same look as the awful, but they're better. No, I mean they're, yeah, they can be read by everyone.
Tamer, yeah.
Yeah. Thank you very much, Barira. Thank you very much, Ibu Tasya, for the questions. And I think we're done with Barira. Thank you very much, Barira, for presenting the book that you have written, you have prepared. Thank you very much. Now we're going to go to the next student presenting about another animal. And I'm going to invite Alpha to join with us here. Hello, Alpha. Good afternoon. Hello, Alpha. How are you?
I'm fine.
I'm fine. Okay, good. Alpha, are you ready to present your book?
Yes.
Yes, okay. So you can start your presentation. Well, Biru has question for Barira, but then, okay, we're going to postpone the question, Biru. Sorry. Okay, Alpha, you can start your presentation. Yeah. Okay. Yes. Okay, talking about monkey. Whoa, that's beautiful picture.
This is my
silakan
cover book. This is my cover book
with monkey. Wah, can you please speak louder, Alpha? Lebih keras suaranya.
This is my cover book.
Okay.
Next, preface. This is my preface. This is table of content, preface, development, chapter 1, chapter 2, chapter 3, chapter 4, chapter 5, and preface. And chapter 1, about characteristic of monkey. Monkey is term for all primate members. Monkey are included in a class of mammals. Chapter 2, about classification monkey. Monkey belong to kingdom Animalia. In phylum, monkey belong to Chordata. In kingdom phylum, definition class are the family genus species. And chapter 3 is about body part, size, style, tail, skin, teeth, hand, feet, age. Chapter 4, about habitat. Many monkey species are dwelling arboreal. Out of their species, they live primarily on the ground, such as pavon. Chapter 5, about benefit and fungification. Some monkey also use circus. There are training of entities and audition with their action. And last one, reference.
Okay, that's all. Thank you very much, Alpha. Well, then I have to mention, I have to emphasize that cover. That's very beautiful. Did you draw it yourself, Alpha? Alpha, gambar sendiri covernya?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. So, how long did you draw, or how long?
Two days.
Yeah, good. I can see from the effort. It is very beautiful. Thank you very much. So, any question for Alpha? She is talking about monkey.
Aku mananya.
Okay, wait a second. Yeah, Anin is going to ask a question. But then, okay, before Anin asks a question to Alpha, then you, everyone can see Alpha's book here in this link. Thank you very much, Ibu Anggi, for sharing us the link. And okay, Anin, what's your question for Alpha, Anin?
Which part do you like the most from the book?
Okay, which part do you like the most from the book? Bagian mana dari buku yang paling Alpha suka? Bukan dari monkey-nya ya, Anin ya? Dari monkey-nya atau dari bukunya nih?
Dari bukunya.
Okay, dari bukunya, from the book. Which part?
Chapter 3.
About why? Kenapa, Alpha?
Because body part
of the monkey is all interesting. Menarik ya, body partsnya. Ya. Ada apa saja tadi yang kamu tuliskan? What all the body parts?
Skin, terus tail, teeth,
eyes, body and many more ya.
Okay. Feet.
Have you ever seen monkey in real life? Alpha pernah melihat monkey di real life?
Iya. Yeah.
Yang suka sama abang-abang itu ya? Topeng monyet ya? Tadi salah satu apa
in the zoo, Pak.
Di mana? Oh, in the zoo juga ya. Oh ya.
Saya mau nanya, Pak.
Oke, okay, Kendra, you have a question.
Do any monkeys live in our environments like near our houses or yes?
Oke. Okay. Pertanyaannya, apakah oke, okay, do monkeys live in our environment? Misalnya di sekitar kita. Oh, Pak, apakah monkey bisa Alpha, menurut Alpha bagaimana? Kendra has a question. Can monkey lives in our environment? Around us, for example, in our surroundings. It means that they can live with us, people. Bisa nggak Alpha seperti itu?
Maybe yes, because as the pet.
Okay, maybe people can have it as a pet, right? But, oh, I'm so poor about that one, about the monkey, if the people pet them. Okay, Andin? Any questions, Anin, for Alpha?
Yeah, why did you choose monkey to write in your book?
Okay, thank you, Anin. Alpha, why did you choose monkey? Kenapa milih monkey, Alpha? Why did you choose monkey for your book?
Because I think there's a book unique.
Because monkey is unique. Okay, and it's also smart, right? Monkey is one of smart animal as well. Okay, that's it, Anin. Because monkey is unique and it's smart. Okay, any other questions for Alpha? Well, she has a very beautiful drawing. She can draw beautifully. All right. So if there's no more questions for Alpha, thank you very much, Alpha, for presenting your book about monkey. Again, I have to mention, I'm your fan. Your drawing is a beautiful. Thank you very much, Alpha. Okay, Alpha has presented her book about monkey, and she has a very good drawing. Well, then I'm going to go to the next student, which is Edu. Hello, Edu. I'm going to invite Edu to join with me here to present the book that he has prepared. Hello, Edu. Okay, Edu, maybe you can button up your shirt first. Okay, wear your uniform properly. And then you can start presenting about, okay, if I'm not mistaken, it's about cheetah, right? Okay, can you hear my voice, Edu? You're still, please unmute your voice first.
Yes.
Yes, it's about cheetah, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so yeah, Eddie, you can start your presentation.
Okay.
Wow, cheetah is interesting. It's going to be interesting, yeah. What? Cheetah or rhino? Oh, I've got the wrong information here. You're talking about rhino.
Yeah.
Okay, that's right. No, not cheetah. Oh, I was thinking about cheetah.
So
okay.
My science project is about rhino. Yeah. These are the table of content. Yeah. So chapter one is about rhinos. The rhinos are in the 20th century, the first rhino ever lived.
Okay.
And chapter two, all rhinoceros are herbivores. And chapter two is about classification. Types and classification about rhino. Chapter three, the body parts of rhino, small eyes, one horn or two, nostrils, prehensile lips, hoof feet, stumpy legs, tail, rump, armor plated appearance, just gray skin and small ears. And these are the picture of it.
Okay.
Chapter four is about rhino's natural habitat. So rhinos are the second largest animal on the land. Horse, zebra, and tapir are the closest relatives of rhinos. Rhinos can live to 40 or 45 years in the wild. Rhinos are herbivores. They only eat grass, shrubs, leaves, and shoots. And rhinos interact in every different ways. They talk the same way as human, but in different languages. Extensively one to another, they flatten their ear to warn animal about of their bash their head into a bush. Chapter five is about benefits and function. There are five kingdom of living things, animal, plants, protists. The function of rhinos actually are for helping the workers of the farm. And yeah, that's it.
Okay, that's all about rhino. Okay. So have you got any drawing here? The ones that you draw yourself?
Here. Photoshop, actually.
Okay, you're making a Photoshop.
I didn't finish it, actually, because of the title.
All right. So maybe you can work faster on this one, right? This one is good. You edit the photo beautifully. Thank you very much, Edu. You can close your screen and stop your screen sharing, and we are going to have like some discussion. Okay, good. So Edu is talking about rhino. So why rhino, Edu? Why did you choose rhino?
Because they are what is it called? Almost extinct. So I want to tell all of you.
Okay, they are endangered animals and they're almost extinct. Thank you very much. Okay, so you have got like your concern about this one. Okay, so Bangi, can you please again show us the link where we can get Edu's book? Ibu Anggi, can you please thank you for the screen? Thank you very much, everyone. You can see Edward's Edu or Edu's book here in this link. He has tried to put some information about rhino. Thank you very much, Ibu Anggi. So, okay, any questions for Edu?
I have one.
Okay, so who is that? Is that Abin? Okay, Abin.
So, yeah. If you pick rhino, do you ever see one in real life without you looking at YouTube or Google Image?
Okay. I haven't seen rhino. But I wish I could see someday.
Okay.
Before it extinct, right? Okay. And we hasn't seen rhino. Anyone has ever seen rhino in real life?
Actually, I do. Oh, I believe do. It's like when my mom, when I was like, I haven't moved in Pilar, I think. when we went somewhere, I think it's Australia, never mind, I mean daerah in Indonesian daerah, I think we saw one rhino, only one, sleeping in water.
Alright, that's going to be very interesting to see a rhino, because rhino, it right now, rhino is hard to be seen. They're categorized as endangered animal, and we have some people, some organization have tried their best to actually help the rhino survive. We even had like a certain operation just to save one or two rhinos in this wildlife, because as we know that it's hard for them to actually breed, or they need help to be able to produce kids or generation. It's hard for them. So fact about Ryan. So thank you, Abin, for the question. Any other questions for Edward?
Atago, just yes, curious. Ibu. Can I ask Edu? Edu?
Yes, Ibu Tasya.
You wrote in chapter 3, is it chapter 3, that in the beginning, rhinos live at a certain time. What century is it? 20th century. So it's like 19 something. Is it?
Okay, is it? No one, I do. Okay, maybe you can give more information about that one, I do, the Ibu Tasya later on, right? Especially talking about that
mulai,
one.
Mulai hidupnya gitu ya, mulai hidupnya. Tahun 1900-an.
Iya.
Okay. Maybe earlier than that one. Okay, I do. So, okay, we have a question from Ibu Ika. Okay, we have a question from Ibu Ika, Edu. So, this is from YouTube. Ibu Ika watch us from YouTube, and Ibu Ika has a question. Hi, Edu. What were the skills you developed when working on this project? Okay, Ibu Ika asks you, what were the skills you developed when you working, sorry, when working on this project, Edu?
The skill. Basically,
I do.
Keep working hard, I guess.
Okay. You have to work hard. This is the skill that Edu has learned, Ibu Ika, from this project, that he has to work harder to finish a project, right? Well, yeah, we know that we need to work hard in every project. Thank you very much. Any other questions for Edu? If no, then thank you very much, Edu, for giving us some information about this rhino, because this one is very interesting animals, and it actually has a very big, role in our environment. Thank you very much, Edu. And now we're going to go to the next one. I think the last students to present a book for today's part, because we still have some other parts. I'm going to talk about this one before Diki, which is the next presenter, the next students to talk, is going to present his book. So the next part, or part 3, will be on Wednesday, 26th of August 2020, and will be at the same time right now. This is from 1:45 to 2:45. Okay, that's the part 3. So Diki, are you ready to present your book, Diki?
Ready.
Yes. So what animals are you going to talk?
Butterfly.
Okay, butterfly. Okay, Diki, you may start. You can start your presentation.
Share screen, Pak.
Yes, please share your screen.
Bentar,
Pak. Yes, okay. Take your time, Diki. Everything. Yeah, so as we know, the students have tried to research. They have developed some skills, research skills, they also try to collaborate with all the teachers that has this interlink projects, which is science, ICT, English, and okay, also art. Yeah, it's okay, Diki. Okay, tell me when you're ready for this one. And yeah, this is a good way, actually, one of the good ways for us to learn, for the students to learn, so that they can relate, actually. They create one project, but this project is actually linked to some subjects they are learning. So like, for example, in English, we're talking about describing something, to describe animals, to describe plants, and many things. Okay, I think DK has shared his screen. Okay, we're going to wait for DK to share his screen. Yeah, as I've told you before, that they have to also draw the cover of their book. Pak Henry, the art teacher, has what is guided them in the process of drawing the book cover. So can you please show us the file, the PDF of your book, Diki? Yeah, yours.
Bentar dulu, Pak. Hilang itunya. Okay. File-nya keselip kemana, nggak tahu. Bentar, aku cari.
Okay, wait a second. Maybe Ibu Anggir or Pak Henry, can you please help us with the file? Okay, maybe you can stop your screen, Diki. So that for, yeah, your teachers have it, and yes, we're going to help you.
Salah.
Pak Henry atau Ibu Anggi, can you please help us?
Maybe you have the... Ini, gue nggak share screen, tau gue sendiri.
Share screen, terus yang pencet screen itu coba.
Okay, so we can see Diki's book here. Actually, we have put Diki's book here in this link. So maybe Ibu Anggi or Pak Henry has the file that is ready to be shared. Yes, here. Okay, so okay, Diki, you take your time to prepare your book, the presentation. Yeah.
Ini muka gua, okay, kan?
So this is.
Pak ngelek.
Yeah, this is. Okay, well. We're trying to help Diki with the book that he has prepared. It's butterfly. Diki, we've got the book. We've got the file with us. Can you hear my voice?
What?
Yeah, we've got the book here. We're going to help you with the file. So this is your cover, right? Okay, you can start your presentation here. Diki, Henry will help you. Okay, Diki. Please start your presentation. Please present the book that you have written.
Nih, langsung ke bukunya.
Yeah, okay. You can see the book, right? You can see your book.
Yeah.
Okay.
I will explain about butterfly.
Okay. So what's this?
Preface.
Okay, what do you have in this preface?
Praise be to Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. Praise to be to Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, who has given much favor, tawfiq, and hidayah. So I complete a paper that my book within things.
Okay, so maybe you can continue the next part, Diki. You don't need to read all parts of the book. Okay, this one, chapter one. What do you have here?
Butterfly are insects in the Marco Lepidae do Tehran.
What was that, Diki? What is that?
Itu. Betul ini dalam apa namanya ininya? Butterfly insects in the Macrolepidotheren from the order Lepidoptera, which also includes moths.
Okay, what are you talking about here, Diki, in this introduction? What information do you put here?
Audionya kresek error.
So you cannot hear my voice, Diki?
Putus-putus.
Okay, so I think it's not me. Okay, so what do you write here? You try to introduce butterfly, right? Okay, this is the introduction part. Maybe we can go to the next part, Pak Henry. Okay, so many information. Actually, so many information. So what's this, Diki?
Yeah.
This is chapter 2.
Suaranya putus-putus. Nggak kedengeran.
Okay, Diki, this is chapter 2. You have written chapter 2, which is the classification. We have kingdom, animalia, phylum, arthropoda, and so on. So,
lewat aja, Pak, lewat chat.
Okay.
Let him read the chat.
Yeah. Okay, I'm going to chat Diki. Can I chat Diki here? Wait a second. Yes. Diki. Okay, I have sent a chat to Diki. Diki, can you read my chat, my message? Okay, maybe he has a technical problem with it. So Diki has tried to classify, has put the classification, the data, the information about butterfly here. As we can see, we have phylum, class, order, family, genus, and species. Okay, can you please continue, Pak Henry? I'm going to help Diki to present this. Later on with Diki, if Diki has a better connection or better, what is? Or maybe he doesn't, what is, experience any problem, maybe he could present it. This one, she has put like so many information. The name monarchs is believed to have been on an okay King William. That's interesting. Actually, we have some interesting topic here. Diki, can you hear my voice, Diki?
Sekarang udah bisa nih, Pak.
Okay, so please continue presenting the book. It's still mute, Diki. Please unmute first.
The monarch butterfly, or simply monarch, Danaus plexippus, is a milkweed butterfly. Subfamily dan apa sih itu Pak bacanya, Pak?
Yeah, you're the one who wrote it. What are you writing here?
Danae in the family Nymphalidae.
Okay, continue, Pak Henry. Okay, maybe we can go to the next part. This is talking about classification with some Latin names. Okay, what's that? What are these? There are. Okay, are you going to talk about this one, Diki?
There are 6 subspecies and 2 color morphs of the plexippus have been identified.
Okay, we have six. Okay, then let's go to the next one, Pak Andri. Since we have a very limited time here. Okay, and what's this, Diki, in chapter 3? What do you have? Please unmute. Stay unmute,
Diki. Like all insects, they have six joint legs, three body parts, a pair of antenna, compound eyes, and exoskeleton.
Okay, do you have the picture, Diki? Okay, so that's the picture.
Untuk bedain cowok sama cewek.
Bedanya apa, Diki? What's the differences between male and female?
Kalau yang cewek lebih gelap.
Yang cowok lebih terang. Oke, okay. Ukurannya sama ya, Diki ya?
Iya. Oke. Okay.
Then, what else, Diki? Again, there's another monarch butterfly. Okay. Do you want to say something about this picture, Diki? Hello, Diki. Do you want to say something about this picture?
Apaan?
Okay. Do you want to say something about this picture? We've got two, a picture of two butterflies here.
Itu yang putih di Sumatera.
Yang coklat, yang oranye?
Yang oranye itu ada di Meksiko.
Wah, jauh banget ya. Tapi bisa jadi satu frame gitu ya. Nggak ada bercanda. Oke, okay. Itu yang satu Sumatera, yang satu dari Meksiko.
Oke. Okay. Yeah.
So they can live in this what is climate di iklim kita, Diki?
Kenapa?
Di Indonesia bisa hidup ya, walaupun dari Meksiko mereka tetap bisa hidup di Indonesia ya.
Bisa.
Oke, okay, good, thank you. Next, what this? Okay, do you want to say something about this, Diki?
Itu daur hidupnya kupu-kupu.
Okay. Then, okay, we can see that larva, pupa, adults, and so on. What else? Next, maybe Pak Henry, can you please continue the screen? Or oh, that's the last page. Okay, this is the habitat.
The monarch can be found in many different kinds of habitats. When it is breeding, it is found in habitats with milkweed, a kind of plant. Some of these habitats include fields, meadows, prairies, parks in or near cities, gardens and roadsides.
Okay, roadsides. Yes. Thank you. And then, is that all? The habitat, after the habitat, what else do you have, Diki?
Apa?
Okay, what else after the habitat? What things you mentioned in your book? After the habitat, what do you have? Okay, benefit and function. So what's the function of a butterfly, the benefit of a butterfly.
Function itu gak tahu.
Okay, so you can okay. See from here. Mm-hmm.
they face deforestation in and around their Mexican wintering grounds, increased exposure to pesticides
and lost nectar. Okay, then. So, well, I don't see any what is function here from butterfly. Kenapa sih kupu-kupu tuh ngapain sih dia? Fungsinya buat apa kupu-kupu di kehidupan nyata? Di maksudnya, apakah dia membantu petani untuk menyebarkan benih atau apakah dia sebagai hama atau bagaimana di game menurut kamu? Kupu-kupu.
Kurang tahu.
Oke, nanti dicari tahu lagi ya Diki, karena kupu-kupu, yeah. All, butterflies, although it's like a very small animal, but it has a very big part in our ecosystem. Again, it has a very big part of in our ecosystem. Well, thank you very much, Diki. Is there any more things you want to say? And this is the references that you're... Okay, maybe that's all. Thank you very much, Pak Henry, for helping us with the screen sharing. Any questions for Diki about the book? About butterflies, and he's talking about monarch butterfly, for example, specifically about monarch butterfly. Is there any questions for Diki? We can open one or two questions.
Can I ask one question?
Yes, Ibu Tasya.
Diki, why did you choose butterflies as your book? Are you interested so much in butterflies or butterflies? Yeah. What is it? How do you feel in two butterflies? Do you like it very much? You adore butterflies? You have a collection of butterflies?
Suka butterfly aja.
Suka aja. Okay. Yeah. Any kind of a special kind of butterflies? The big ones, the small ones, the colorful ones?
Gak tahu itunya.
Okay.
Why do you like
Diki,
butterflies?
You do more research on butterflies, okay?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you very much.
Yes, thank you, Butasya. So, Diki, I agree with you, Butasya, that Diki needs to... do more research about butterfly because this one is actually a very beautiful animal. It has a very big part in our ecosystem and we do need butterfly. Okay, so is there any more questions? One more question maybe from Dicky's friend here. Anyone wants to ask him a question?
I have a question, but...
Okay, is it... Faldi, okay. Faldi, you have a question, Faldi? Your camera, Faldi.
Okay. So, what is the most enjoyable part of for making this book?
Okay, so Faldi is asking about the process of making the book, right, Faldi? Which one is the most interesting part?
Making the cover.
Okay, making the cover. Yeah, since okay, Diki has very good cover as well. So for Diki, making the cover is the most interesting part, Valdi.
What about besides the cover?
Okay, can you please mention the other things besides the cover, Diki?
Gak, cuma itu doang.
Okay, cuma itu doang, Valdi. Cuma itu. Okay, creating the cover is the most interesting part. Well, it's okay. This is personal opinion, right? So, in Dicky's opinion, creating the cover of this butterfly is the most interesting part. Okay, Biru, you have a question, Biru. What makes butterfly? Okay, Biru, ask yourself, please say it yourself, Biru, your question.
What makes butterfly wings colorful?
Okay, what makes the butterfly wings colorful? Have you got any information about it, Dicky?
Gak tahu, belum research.
Okay, Dicky will do another research for this one, Biru. So maybe he will tell you later on when he found out, when he will find out the question, sorry, the answer. Okay, Dicky, one more question from Ibu Ika. Hi, Dicky. This is from Ibu Ika. She's watching you in YouTube. How do butterflies protect themselves from predator, Dicky? Do you have any information about this? Ibu Ika asks you, how do butterflies protect themselves from predator? That's a very good and a very hard question anyway. So do you have any information about this?
Apa tadi pertanyaannya?
How do butterflies protect themselves from predator? Bagaimana mereka melindungi dirinya dari pemangsanya? Apa yang butterfly lakukan?
Apa ya? Melipat sayapnya
tadi. Okay, maybe folding the wings, or maybe there are some other strategies or method of.
Sama berkamuflase.
Camouflage, good. I think so. That's one thing that butterflies do to protect themselves from predator. Camouflage. Their colors. Sometimes, yeah, they use their colors to camouflage. There are some certain butterflies that has like a color of wood skin, then that people will hard to see the butterfly. Okay, I think that's all from us. The question, Dicky, thank you very much for presenting the information about butterfly. Yeah, we know that. Okay, you're going to do more research about this one because there are some questions that needs more information. Like, for example, what makes their wings colorful? How do they protect themselves? And what are the most interesting thing about butterfly and so on? Okay, later on, we hope that Dicky can do more research about this one. Okay, thank you very much, Dicky. And okay, so that's the end of our virtual presentations for today. This is the second part of virtual interlink project virtual presentation from grade 7. We still have two more parts for this virtual presentation, which are going to be done on Wednesday, the 26th of August, and also on Friday, the 28th of August. So thank you very much for joining with us. Thank you very much, parents. Thank you very much, students, and everyone who has joined us to this virtual presentation. And we are so grateful that our students can do their best. They can show very good effort. And again, thank you very much for joining with us. We hope that this activity can be beneficial for everyone here. So from me, thank you very much, and we'll see you in our next presentation. Bye, everyone. See you.
Bye. Thank you.